Sri Lanka, the so-called pearl of the Indian Ocean, a country with a rich heritage of over 2,000 years, a country in which Buddha himself set foot and blessed, a country where nature and humanity meets, a country where culture, religion and devotion is the only way of life, a country where families come first. Despite the beauty and serenity, Sri Lanka is also a country where bombs exploded every other day. A country where innocent people were victims of a war they did not want. A country where humanity depleted. A country where the culture, religion, devotion all came crashing down. A country where families were lost.
முள்ளிவாய்க்காலால் இப்போ இந்த முகாமுக்கு போய் முகாமில் இருந்து இப்போ இந்த திருப்பி இங்கே உணர்ந்து விட்டேன்.
நாங்கள் இங்கே மாதிரிலேருந்து சொன்னிதஞ்சில் இடம் பேர்ந்து வன்னிக்கு போனோம். வன்னியிலேருந்து இப்போ இந்த இடம் பேர்ந்து அப்படி ஒவ்வொரு முகாமாக தெரிஞ்சு பிறகு புது மாத்தடன் வன்னிக்கு அங்கே போனோம். அங்கே போய் எங்களோட மகளுக்கு வங்கதுக்கு வீட்டுக்கு செல்விழுந்து தாயும் தகப்பனும் ஒரு பிள்ளையும் வளர்ந்தினோம். பிறகு இவா பேட்டி தான் தப்பினோம். அதை நான் தான் வளர்த்துவாங்க.
Today, Sri Lanka is a country that calls war a thing of the past. Caught in the middle of the brutal 30 years of this conflict were innocent people who, for absolutely no reason of their own, were being tossed into the thick of it all, from both sides. Whether it was being displaced from their homes or being attacked in the streets by suicide bombers, innocent people had to bear the brunt. War was so engraved in Sri Lankan society that even after it ended in 2009, words such as rebuilding, rehabilitation and reconstruction remained synonymous with the conflict. It is at this time that the Red Cross, an organization that strives to aid the most vulnerable, launched a program to help affected communities rebuild homes in the north of Sri Lanka. When we began in 2010, we began small.
And when they return, it's not easy for them to build up their own lives just on their own. Sri Lanka Red Cross have felt that. It is a big effort, those people, to build their houses, rebuild their lives, find livelihood. Things are, of course, generally okay. But that doesn't mean people cannot forget what they went through. It's not easy for them. So we have felt to be beside them. We feel that we have to be beside them.
The post-conflict recovery program of Sri Lanka Red Cross, supported by the International Federation of Red Cross and Red Crescent Societies, began by providing cash grants to people who needed a helping hand to rebuild their lives after the war. Initially, the program began with support from various partner national societies across the world. Later on, in 2012, the government of India, providing additional funding, supported to expand this project to cover over 17,000 families, bringing the total support to over 21,000 families. It is an integrated program that provides comprehensive packages of support to resettling communities. The program focuses on two main components: the construction and repair of houses and promoting better sanitation and hygiene. The other components include community infrastructure, livelihoods, health and care, disaster management and organizational development, with the aim of making these communities more sustainable and resilient. This is Kokilarani, who lives in Malawi in the town of Mulathu, which was a hotbed of conflict. She has seen her fair share of tragedy.
ஒரு ஆட்டுக்கொட்டில் ஒன்று இருந்தால் ஆட்டுக்கொட்டிலாம் இருந்தாங்க. ஜிஎஸ் ஊடாக தான் முதல் வந்து எங்கள்கிட்ட ஜிஎஸும் இன்னும் ஒரு சேரும் வந்தவர். அப்போ அவரும் வந்து எல்லாம் பார்த்துட்டு எல்லாத்தையும் பதிவுகள் எல்லாம் எடுத்துக்கொண்டு வருமானங்கள் எல்லாம் கேட்டு பதிஞ்சு கொண்டு போய் பேந்ததுக்கு அப்புறம் ஒரு 3-4 மாதத்துக்கு அப்புறம் தான் பேந்து எங்களை வீடு பாஸ் பண்ணி வந்தது.
எண்ட் ஆஃப் தி கம்ப்ளீட் இன் 2009 தி கவர்மெண்ட் இம்மிடியட்லி ஸ்டார்ட் த ரீசெட்மெண்ட் ப்ரோக்ராம். ரெட் கிராஸ் ஆஸ் அ மூமெண்ட் ஐடென்டிஃபை த நீட் ஆஃப் த பீப்புள் ஹூ ஆர் கோயிங் டு ரீசெட்டில் இன் தீஸ் ஏரியாஸ். ஆஸ் அ ரிசல்ட் ஆஃப் தட் ரெட் கிராஸ் இஸ் செல்ஃப் இனிஷியேட்டட் பர்மனன்ட் ஹவுசிங் ப்ரோக்ராம் வித் த சப்போர்ட் ஆஃப் Red Cross partners.
The major chunk of this housing project under the owner-driven process. I would say this is one of the best examples of the process innovations. It is a good process innovation model wherein it is unique in every sense. It's the way the number of beneficiaries involved in this and the magnitude of money involved in the process and the especially the mode of implementation, how the owner-driven processes, whole things happening.
One of the biggest challenge that we faced was the selection of right beneficiary. And because there are huge need and demand of the houses, because hundreds and thousands of people displaced and everybody wanted house. So how to select the right beneficiary was an initial challenge. But with the thankful support from the different government officials, especially the DSS and GA, we have managed to successfully select the house, all beneficiary at this stage.
Once the beneficiary is selected, the Red Cross provides technical support to help build their homes. This happens in 4 stages, where the complete grant of 550,000 rupees is given in 4 installments. The first stage is to lay the foundation, the next to construct walls, the third to complete the roof, and the fourth to complete the house.
மற்றது மண் ஏற்றி கொடுத்துனாங்க, கல் ஏற்றி கொடுத்துனாங்க, தண்ணி அதில் தூரத்தில் இருந்து அங்கே இருந்தாலும் அள்ளி கொண்டு வருவோம் தண்ணி கையில்தானே, அந்த குழா பைப்பு அதில் தான் அடித்து கொண்டு கொடுத்துனாங்க.
This project is implemented as a partnership between the Red Cross and the beneficiary. From the start, both parties are actively involved in the rebuilding process. And the beneficiary has a key say in how his or her home will be built.
Actually, this is not a village initially. This was a highland jungle. That time, Red Cross and government parties entered to the village to see the actual things of this land. We all decided here we can provide around 14 to 17 numbers of beneficiaries. Here, no any access route. So beneficiaries can't bring their building materials to this site. So we had many more challenges.
As we continue towards our target of building over 21,000 houses, we meet people from various walks of life. Meet our youngest beneficiary. She lives in Mavagal in Jaffna. She's just 10 years old.
எனது அம்மாவின் பேர் சுரேகா, அப்பாவின் பேர் துபேஷ்குமார், என் தம்பியின் பேர் கோமகன்.
But today, Kalaivali does not have her mother, her father or her brother. All of them were killed by a shell attack when she was just 4 years old.
பிறகுதா பேத்திதான் தப்பினோம், அதை நான் தான் வளர்த்து வரேன். அப்போ அதுக்கு பிறகு நாங்கள் பேருந்து அங்கே இருந்து இங்கே வந்து 2010 இங்கே இருந்து அப்புறம் நாங்கள் வந்து கொட்டியில் வசித்து வந்தோம். இவ்வளவு நான் தான் வளர்த்து வரேன். மெத்த மகன் நேரத்திக்கணும், மகன் சதீஷு உதவியை செய்வரங்களுக்கு படிப்பு விஷயம். நான் தோட்ட வேலையில் போய் மாடுண்டு வளர்த்தா இல்லை பால் எடுத்து கொடுத்து அவள் வளர்த்துறேன்.
Kalaivali is the only person from her extended family who qualified for a housing grant from the post-conflict recovery program's Indian Housing Project. However, since she is still a minor, the Red Cross worked with government authorities to appoint her grandmother as a guardian until she is of legal age.
First of all, of course, it's our mandate to support vulnerable people by any means. It's a reason number one. Second, I think it's very important to highlight that our previous experience, our, I'm talking not only Federation, but first of all Sri Lanka Red Cross Society, with the support of Federation, our experience collected during the 10 years of post-tsunami operation, where we did construction together with the other partners, you know, in many areas, not only in the north. So that's why I think that those reasons were definitely taken into consideration.
Building over 21,000 houses that would house more than 100,000 people is no easy task. For us at the Red Cross, this was only possible due to the hard work of over 100 staff scattered all over the five districts in the north.
During the implementation, so our staff, they have to go and visit the beneficiary very frequently. Lack of infrastructure facilities, not good proper roads, and lack of access. So they have to walk sometimes, and then even by motorbike it's very difficult to go, and under the sun, hot sun, they have to go every day, and it's not an easy task for them to do.
The post-conflict recovery program has had many donors. Partner national societies like the Norwegian Red Cross, the German Red Cross and the Australian Red Cross initially helped lay the foundation to ensure this project gets off the ground. Later on, the Government of India entrusted Sri Lanka Red Cross in partnership with the International Federation of Red Cross and Red Crescent Societies to build over 17,000 houses for the Indian housing project in the north.
The implementing agencies played a very key role in this housing and continue to play a very key role in this housing project. IFRC is concentrating its activities in Jaffna, in Mulaitivu, in Kilinochi and Manar. So I think the bulk of the housing in the north, for instance, IFRC has taken a very heavy caseload, and I'm happy that the progress has been very good and a large number of houses have been constructed.
The Red Cross is doing a good job, and I appreciated their works, a very good coordination and a very good transfer manner they are doing. I have very good experience with the Red Cross for implementing many projects, including housing and other livelihood activities and other projects also, period. We have a very good coordination between the Red Cross and our government officials and the divisional level also. That's why their projects are being implemented successfully, I think.
The post-conflict recovery program was initiated by the Red Cross to help people who were returning to their homeland after 30 years of conflict. Since 2010, we have been doing our best to ensure that we provide the best humanitarian service possible to the people who were at the forefront of vulnerability.
Most important thing for me is to see the smiles on the faces of the people who have been supported with the houses. And if somebody asks what is the impact, I would certainly say the smiles on the faces of the beneficiary. That is really one of the most encouraging factors.
We gave our priority for the permanent houses, but we identified so many other needs as well. We expand our program to cover those areas as much as possible, especially for the beneficiaries who are covered under the Red Cross funding for permanent housing. We provided them livelihood support. In the same time, we gave so many trainings on disaster management, on health and first aid issues, mind risk education. So many areas we covered under our program.
எங்களுடைய மடப்பிரதேசத்தை பொறுத்த மட்டிலே மிக குறைந்த அளவு அரசு சார்பற்ற நிறுவனங்கள் தான் பணியாற்றிய நிலையில் செஞ்சிலுவை சங்கத்தினுடைய பங்களிப்புன்றது மிகவும் முக்கியமான ஒன்றாக காணப்படுகின்றது. பெருமளவான பங்களிப்பை செஞ்சிலுவை சங்கம் செய்திருக்கிறது என்று சொல்லலாம்.
We ask head of the man who is the head of the family, what is this house means for you? What does this house means for you, for your family? His answer was clear. This house, it's a strong foundation for my family, for all of us, for the future. Based on this strong foundation, we can build how many floors we would like. But if it will be weak foundation, all further constructions will fail and all these constructions will fall down. That's why I do believe that right now, majority of our beneficiaries, they really consider it as a strong foundation for their future.
Today on the contrast, when we go around in our jeep, they start waving us from far away. That's the difference. They have recognized someone who has come and done something. And their lives are back to normal. When they go, when we try to go and see them, sort of approach them, to go into their house, they run inside to make some tea and coffee. Today, it's the community who are the mobilizers. Their own people are helping them. It is our staff and now the same people from the community. That's how far we have come.
As the program ends, we are proud to have been able to provide 21,125 houses, allowing over 105,000 people to call it their home. Over 200,000 people provided with better water and sanitation facilities. An additional 35,000 people provided with direct livelihood support. And all in all, over 400,000 people benefiting directly and indirectly from the support provided by the Red Cross Post-Conflict Recovery Program.
உடுவில் முதல் இருந்த நாங்கள் இடம் பெயர்ந்து போன நேரம் எங்களுக்கு இருக்கையோ இடம் இல்லாமல் நாங்கள் மரத்துக்கெல்லாம் போன உடனே நாங்கள் இருந்தோம்.
அதில் அங்கே சிறடி இங்கே சிறடி தான் இங்கே வந்து சேர்ந்து 2010 இங்கே வந்து
இருந்து நாங்கள் இவ்வளோ கஷ்டப்பட்டோம்.
மரத்து மட்டுகளுக்கு இருந்தோம்.
சரியான வறட்சி தான், காடுகள் பத்தியல் தான்,
சும்மா கொட்டில் போட்டு தான் இருந்த நாங்கள்.
மழை வந்தால் கூட நாங்கள் படிக்கிறதுக்கோ சமைக்கிறதுக்கோ தூங்குறதுக்கோ
பிறகு இந்த எங்களுக்கு இந்த எண் விட்டுட்டாங்க கிடைச்சாது.
இப்போ நிம்மதியாக இருக்கிறோம், நிம்மதியாக இருக்கிறோம், நிம்மதியாக இருக்கிற ஒரு பிரச்சனையும் இல்லை, நல்லா இருக்கிறோம் நாங்கள்.